Okay, assalamu alaikum students, good afternoon. Am I audible to everyone?
वालेकुम अस्सलाम सर। यस सर।
Okay, that's all right. So, let's start with today's lecture. And one very important thing is कि आज का लेक्चर बड़ा इंटरेस्टिंग इस वजह से है कि दिस लेक्चर इज गोइंग टू गिव यू अ न्यू आइडिया ऑफ क्वांटम क्रिप्टोग्राफी, राइट? So you people have to learn. I mean, you have to be very conscious about this lecture, and you have to, listen it very carefully. And if you got an idea of quantum cryptography, so हमें पता है ना, asymmetric is a possibility that it might compromise. I mean, it might be compromised such site of type of encryption. But when we are talking about a quantum cryptography, this is a very new idea, and it is very difficult to compromise any type of communication that is being encrypted by a quantum encryption, right? So this topic is being included in today's lecture. So you have to be very much careful for today's lecture, right? So let's start with our today's lecture. First of all, no, not this one. 24, no. Yeah, this one, right? So in our previous lecture, we have discussed regarding S-MIME. So these three or four slides are going to represent or are going to tell us about the previous lecture. Secure MIME is a standard for encrypting and digitally signing electronic mail and for providing secure data transmission. As we have discussed in our last lecture, MIME and secure MIME is going to provide us that how an email can be secured over a communication link, right? By providing a digitally signing methodology, we are going to secure our email when somebody is going to send and receive an email over a network, right? The encryption and hashing algorithms can be specified by the user of the mail package instead of having it dictated to them. Now see, if you need to encrypt your email, or if you need to apply hashing algorithm or integrity information over your email, you have to specify that particular information when you are sending or receiving an email, right? So this is how your secure MIME works, and the main responsibility of secure MIME protocol is to in order to I mean main responsibility is to encrypt your email communication that is being done over a network, right? That we have discussed in detail yesterday, right? S-MIME provides confidentiality through encryption algorithm that I have told you yesterday, right? That I mean confidentiality service जो है वो हमारी encryption algorithm के through मिलती है, either it is symmetric, asymmetric or whatsoever it could be. Integrity through hashing algorithm, we know that integrity service is always been achieved with the help of hashing algorithm. Authentication through the use of X.509 Kerberos protocol, I mean digital signatures or certificate that is called as your public certificate के through हम authentication achieve करते हैं, and non-repudiation through cryptographically signed message digest that is called as MD, right? So this is how you are going to achieve all these services in by using secure MIME. I mean encryption, integrity, authentication, non-repudiation, and all these things, right? Now we also have discussed regarding Pretty Good Privacy. It was designed by Phil Zimmerman as a freeware email program and was released in 1991, right? It was the first widespread public key encryption algorithm. PGP is a complete crypto system that uses a cryptographic protection to protect email and files. I mean, we have discussed it was being released in 1991. It is the first public key encryption program. It is a complete crypto system. I have already told you कि जी आपके पास ये crypto system है that uses certain sort of cryptographic protection programs to protect your emails and files, right? And we also have discussed it can use RSA public key encryption for key management and use IDEA symmetric cipher for bulk encryption of data. Although the user has the option of picking different types of algorithm for these functions. So this is very important. I think we have discussed three or four different email standards yesterday, which are going to provide security during the email communication, and one of them was Pretty Good Privacy, right? So I mean you need to learn or you need to understand regarding these standards that what type of public key cryptographic algorithm they are using and how the data is being encrypted. I mean, by what algorithm, right? So if we are talking about, it can use RSA public key encryption for key management and use IDEA symmetric cipher for bulk encryption of data. ठीक है, RSA आपके पास होता है key management के लिए और IDEA जो है that is being used for symmetric cipher for bulk encryption of data, right? So although the user has the option of picking up different types of algorithm for their these functions, right? So this is regarding the pretty good privacy. PGP can provide confidentiality by using the IDEA encryption algorithm. Right, again we need to learn the same thing that we have discussed in our previous algo. I mean, how we are achieving confidentiality? We are going to achieve the confidentiality by using IDEA encryption algorithm. We are going to achieve integrity service by using MD5 hashing algorithm. Now see, this is bit specific. Yahan pe hum mention kar rahe hain ki not only hashing algorithm but MD5 hashing algorithm is being implemented in pretty good privacy, right? Authentication by using the public key certificate that we have discussed in our last, in the previous slide, and non-repudiation by using cryptographically signed message, right? So PGP uses its own type of digital certificate rather than what is being used in PKI, but they both have similar purposes, right? Their digital certificate might be different from the PKI, but they both have the same functionality to perform, right? That we have discussed. Now we need to start our new topic that is called as quantum cryptography, right? It's very interesting and this is a new idea also, and you people can work on that also. I mean, if somebody is interested in that particular area, that quantum cryptography, this is a very new idea, not the new idea, but you can have a different version or different way to think in cryptography, right? So first of all, I would like to tell you that what the quantum cryptography is. Because of the need to always build a better algo, some very smart people have mixed quantum physics and cryptography, which has resulted in a system, if built correctly, that is unbreakable and where any eavesdroppers can be detected. Now see, before quantum cryptography, we do have a concept of quantum physics. I mean, quantum technology is being introduced firstly in terms of physics, jo hum normally padhte hain, theek hai? And then quantum physics is going to be interacted with cryptography, and a new concept is being generated that is called as quantum cryptography, right? And which is most secure type of cryptography that up till today, right? And it is very difficult to break that type of crypto system, right? So if it is built correctly, that is unbreakable and where any eavesdropper can be detected. Even after ek cheez to badi important hai ki ek to ye unbreakable, I mean nobody can break that particular algo, right? Secondly, eavesdropper word ka matlab main aapko bata raha hu, eavesdropper is a person who is going to listen somebody communication, listen somebody's information or listen somebody communication that is being done over a network, over a telephone or whatsoever it could be, right? I mean, if somebody is going to listen your communication, over a network, then you may call it as eavesdropper. Now first, it is unbreakable. Secondly, an eavesdropper can easily be detected. I mean, if somebody is going to listen your communication, that it can easily be detected that somebody is trying to listen or trying to sniff your information, right? This is very important point. I mean, normally jo aapki cryptography hoti hai usme agar koi eavesdropper ya koi aapke paas attacker attack launch karta hai to aapko pata nahi chalta if it is successful or not successful, that is something else. I mean, wo successful hota hai ya nahi hota, lekin what type of attack he is launching you cannot आइडेंटिफाई करिए. अगर वो सक्सेसफुल नहीं हो पाता था तो यू मस्ट नॉट बी नोइंग दैट कि जी आपके नेटवर्क के ऊपर इतना बड़ा अटैक हो रहा है और आपको पता ही नहीं है. लेकिन क्वांटम कम्युनिकेशन के अंदर अगर कोई बंदा आपको ईवेसड्रॉप कर रहा है या आपको लिसन करने की कोशिश कर रहा है, इवन इट इज सक्सेसफुल और नॉट सक्सेसफुल, यू केम टू नो, आपका जो रिसीवर से पता चल जाएगा कि आपके डेटा को स्निफ करने की कोशिश की गई है. ठीक है, तो उसकी किस तरह से होता है, दैट वी नीड टू लर्न, राइट? सो इन ट्रेडिशनल क्रिप्टोग्राफी वी ट्राई टू मेक इट वेरी हार्ड फॉर एन ईवेसड्रॉपर टू ब्रेक एन एल्गोरिथम एंड अनकवर अ की, बट वी कैन नॉट डिटेक्ट दैट एन ईवेसड्रॉपर इज ऑन द लाइन. इन क्वांटम क्रिप्टोग्राफी हाउएवर, नॉट ओनली इज द इंक्रिप्शन वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग, बट एन ईवेसड्रॉपर कैन बी डिटेक्टेड. द सेम थिंग दैट आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट, राइट? Okay, quantum cryptography can be carried out using various methods. So we will walk through one version of to review how all this works, right? So let's say, I mean, now we are going to understand this quantum cryptography by understanding the real-time example. I mean, in the previous class, slides, I have told you that how to example like Ali and Bilal and Usman or like that. So in this example, in this situation, we also have to take an example that how quantum cryptography can be implemented. So let's say Tom and Kathy are spies and need to send their data back and forth with assurance it won't be captured. To do so, they need to establish a symmetric encryption key on both ends, one for Tom and one for Kathy. अब देखें समझना है आपने सिनेरियो को. टॉम और कैथी दो स्पाइज हैं एंड दे वांट टू कम्युनिकेट कि कोई और उनकी इंफॉर्मेशन या कम्युनिकेशन को सुन ना सके, ठीक है? एंड दे वांट टू सेंड देयर डेटा बैक एंड फोर्थ विद द अश्योरेंस दैट नोबडी कैन कैप्चर दैट इंफॉर्मेशन, राइट? सो फॉर टू इन ऑर्डर टू इंप्लीमेंट दिस सिचुएशन व्हाट दे हैव डन, दे नीड टू एस्टैब्लिश अ सिमेट्रिक इंक्रिप्शन की. आई मीन symmetric encryption algo they want to implement so that the key can be transferred between two users and then they can encrypt and decrypt the data in a very normal way or phir aapke paas dono side ke upar communication possible, right? This is the situation. Now in quantum cryptography, photon polarization is commonly used to represent bits 1 or 0. Ab ye cheez important hai samajhne ke liye ki photon is an atom sort of thing in physics to hum samajhte hain, theek hai? That polarization, positive or negative, that is being used to represent 1 or 0 in quantum cryptography, right? Polarization is the orientation of electromagnetic waves, right? Which is what photons are. Photons are the particles that make up the light. Aapki jo light travel karti hai na, uski jo particles hote hain, they are being called as photon, right? Now, the polarization of the electromagnetic wave or the orientation of electromagnetic wave is going to be represented by that particular photon. और उसके बाद हम उसकी जो zeros और one को हम उस तरह से measure कर रहे होते हैं. The electromagnetic wave have an orientation of horizontal or vertical or left hand or right hand. अब होता क्या है कि electromagnetic जो wave होती है ना photon मतलब orientation, इसकी जो आपके पास structure होता है, that is something like it is either horizontal or it is vertical, right? That is the first situation. Ya phir wo tilt hoti hai left hand side ko ya right hand side ko. This is the four situations, or you may call it as four situations in which you can generate multiple binary values based on that. वैसे तो हमारे पास दो situations होती हैं, zero and one. लेकिन यहाँ पे आपके पास चार different situations होती हैं. I mean horizontal, vertical, left tilt, right tilt, right? Now think of a photon as a jelly bean. Jelly bean आपने सबने सुना होगा कि jelly bean is a sort of thing that is going to be managed. अब उसकी example वो analogy दे रहा है आपके पास, ठीक है? As a jelly bean flies through the air, it can be vertical, standing up straight. या तो वो आपके पास straight होगी, standing up straight, horizontal, lying on its back. या तो आपके पास वो straight line में होगी, ठीक है जी? Left-handed, tilted onto the left, or right-handed, tilted to the right. This is just to conceptually get your hand around the idea of polarization. अब ये आपको जस्ट बताने के लिए बताया गया है कि polarization होती कैसे है, ठीक है? Electromagnetic wave के अंदर कि जी let's suppose if I'm going to say that कि जी it's vertical, that means that कि आपके पास vertical line जैसे होती है straight, right? Horizontal, I mean they are lying on its back. अगर आपके पास left-handed means that it's left tilted and if or right-handed means it is right tilted, right? So this is the scenario of a photon. Now both Kathy and Tom each have their own photon guns, right? अब यहाँ से photon particles आपके generate होंगे, which they will use to send photons information back and forth to each other. I mean definitely if they want to communicate, they do have certain sort of, जैसे optical fiber के अंदर आपके पास होता है ना LED light emitting diode होती है, that is responsible to take your data in the form of light from source to a destination. And you people are well aware कि optical fiber के अंदर आपका data transmit होता है in the form of light, right? So from where that particular light is coming, there must be some source of light that is being used to transmit your data in the form of light from source to a destination. In the same way, when we are talking about quantum cryptography, so you must have some certain sort of photon gun or like that, which might be used in order to send your data in the form of photons from sender to the receiver, right? So which way they will be used to send photons, that is called as your information, back and forth to each other. So they also have a mapping between the polarization of a photon and a binary value. I mean, we must have to create a relationship between the photon electromagnetic wave and your binary values, right? Now, how can we do that? The polarization can be represented as vertical. If you can see in this particular slide, आपके पास ये वर्टिकल की सिचुएशन है, ये हॉरिजॉन्टल, ये लेफ्ट टिल्टेड और ये राइट टिल्टेड, राइट? लेट मी मेक इट फुल स्क्रीन, राइट? दिस इज लेफ्ट टिल्टेड, दिस इज द वर्टिकल, दिस इज हॉरिजॉन्टल, दिस इज लेफ्ट टिल्टेड और दिस इज राइट टिल्टेड, एंड सिंस वी ओनली हैव टू वैल्यूज इन बाइनरी, देयर मस्ट बी सम ओवरलैप, राइट? नाउ in this example, a photon with a vertical polarization maps to the binary value of zero. अब हम क्या कर रहे हैं कि अपनी जो vertical polarization है उसको हम map कर रहे हैं zero से, I mean binary zero से. A left polarization maps to one. ठीक है जी, जो हमारे पास left polarization है, that we are going to match to one or maps to one. Now a right polarization that maps to zero again. And the horizontal polarization again maps to one. So this mapping or encoding is the binary value that make up an encryption key. अब देखें, अब यहाँ पे ये बात बड़ी important है understand करने के लिए कि this is how you are going to make a key. I mean, if we are going to talk about a normal situation, what we have the random set of values. जब हम symmetric या asymmetric keys use करते हैं, तो we have zeros and ones. The combination of these zeros and ones make up a key or like that, right? That we have gone through in our previous lectures. But when we are talking about a quantum cryptography, there is a photon polarization, and these polarizations are going to be divided into four different spaces. You have four different directions in which you have the vertical polarization, you have the left polarization, you have the right polarization, and then you have the horizontal polarization. And each of that particular polarization maps to each of the value, I mean zeros and ones, right? That I have told you right now in this particular paragraph, right? So now I think that's clear to you guys. I mean, this is how you're going to make an encryption key for this scenario. ठीक है जी, अब नीचे वाले पैराग्राफ पे आ जाएं. Tom must have the same mapping to interpret what Kathy sends to him. अब देखिए दोनों sides के ऊपर आपके पास उसके पास भी इस तरह की interpretation होनी चाहिए जो उसने Kathy को send, Kathy ने उसको send की है. Tom will use this as his map. So when he receives a photon with the polarization of this, he will write down a one. When he receives a photon with polarization of vertical line, he will write down a zero. He will do this for the whole key and use these value as the key to decrypt a message Kathy sends him. अब देखें, Tom ने ये सारी information अपनी photon के through send की और Kathy जो है जो receive कर रहा है, उसने क्या किया? उसने उसको accordingly interpret करके अपने पास एक key generate कर ली based on the information that Tom has sent, right? So this is how they are going to make at both the end similar key, and by using that particular similar key from these polarization values, that randomization is going to create the symmetric key at both the ends, right? Yes, so Tom must have the same mapping. अच्छा जी, यहां तक क्लियर हो गई बात. इज द बाइनरी वैल्यू दैट मेकअप्स एन इंक्रिप्शन की, राइट? सो टॉम मस्ट हैव द सेम मैपिंग टू इंटरप्रेट व्हाट कैथी सेंड्स टू हिम. टॉम विल यूज दिस एज हिज मैप. सो व्हेन ही रिसीव्स अ फोटॉन विद द पोलराइजेशन ऑफ दिस, ही विल राइट डाउन अ वन. व्हेन ही रिसीव्स द फोटॉन विद द पोलराइजेशन ऑफ वर्टिकल लाइन, ही विल राइट डाउन अ जीरो. ही विल डू दिस फॉर द होल की एंड यूज दीज वैल्यूज एज द की टू डिक्रिप्ट अ मैसेज कैथी सेंड्स हिम, राइट? अब देखिए, दोनों साइड्स के ऊपर आपके पास एक सिंक्रोनाइजेशन मैकेनिज्म जनरेट होगा. आई मीन समवन हु हैज सेंड दैट पर्टिकुलर की. अच्छा, मेक श्योर दिस इज नॉट व्हाट वी आर ट्रांसफरिंग द डेटा, हम डेटा ट्रांसफर नहीं कर रहे हैं, हम पहले एक आई मीन टू से दैट एक ऐसा थ्री वे हैंडशेक, आई थिंक इफ यू डू रिमेंबर वी हैव गॉन थ्रू द थ्री वे हैंडशेक बिटवीन द टीसीपी कनेक्टिविटी. जब हम टीसीपी कनेक्शन क्रिएट करते हैं तो वी आर गोइंग टू फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल बाय सेंडिंग द कंट्रोल बिट्स वी आर गोइंग टू क्रिएट अ वर्चुअल कनेक्शन एंड वंस दैट कनेक्शन इज बीइंग क्रिएटेड देन वी स्टार्ट सेंडिंग द डेटा, राइट. सो try to interpret this particular concept in the same way like a TCP three-way handshake is going to be created. In this particular situation, you are going to send the information, that information will be received at the receiver's end, both sender and receiver needs to synchronize, and once they are going to finalize their symmetric keys by sending the photon, electromagnetic waves and all these things, once they are being sure that the symmetric key has been established between the sender and receiver by this mechanism, then they would start sending, encrypting and decrypting the information at both the ends. I mean at the sender's end as well as at the receiver's end, right? So now, so note if it helps, thinks about it this way. Tom receives a jelly bean that is horizontal and right down to one. The next jelly bean he receives is tilted to the right, so he writes a zero. The next jelly bean is vertical, so he writes down to one. He does this for all of the jelly beans Kathy sends his way. Now he has a string of binary values, that is the encryption key his system will use to decrypt the message Kathy sends to him. Actually, ye analogy create kar raha hai jelly beans ke saath. I mean, it is a sort of mechanism that it sends. अगर वो vertical है तो वो उसको one count करेगा. I think one ही count करेगा ना. Yes, he write, sorry. If it is horizontal, he write down to one. I mean your receiver है. If the jelly bean receives is tilted to the right, he would write down a zero. If the next jelly bean is vertical, he write down to one. And if this is again the left tilted, it would be writing a zero or something like that. Now he has to find a complete string at the receiving end also that has been sent by the sender. अब देखें, जो चीज आपकी send होगी और जो आपके पास receive होगी, that must be same, right? If it is same, this means that the both ends have been synchronized and a symmetric key has been established between sender and receiver. Now, if anybody wants to send the data, it would be encrypting that data with that particular symmetric key. And at the same time, when it is receives the data, that is going to be decrypted by the same symmetric key. Ab yahan pe speciality isme kahan pe aati hai? That's what I am going to tell you. Now, so they both have to agree upon a key, which is the mapping between the polarization states of the photon and how those states are represented in a binary value. This happens at the beginning of a communication session over a dedicated fiber line. Now see, this is what I'm going to tell you, that first of all you need to act upon the sending and receiving this particular symmetric key by sending up the photon and receiving the photon of the same values, and you have to map these values with the binary, and once they are being finalized, then we need to start communicating our data. Before that, until these symmetric keys are not being shared, we cannot start communicating. ठीक है, जब हमारे पास वो दोनों चीजें शेयर हो जाएंगी, then we are going to have encryption and decryption and all these things. So once the symmetric key is established, it can be used by Kathy and Tom to encrypt and decrypt the messages that travels over a more public communication path like the internet. The randomness of the polarization and the complexity of creating a symmetric key in this manner help ensure that an eavesdropper will not uncover the encryption key. अब देखिए, यहाँ पे जो important बात understand करने की ये है कि how eavesdropper will not uncover the encryption key. ठीक है, वो कैसे करता है? That we need to understand in our next slide. Encryption तो हो गई आपकी, I mean कोई भी उसको read up नहीं कर सकेगा, लेकिन हमें कैसे पता चलेगा कि let's suppose if somebody is going to listen our information, but if he is successful or not successful, even then your receiver must be knowing that somebody is going to interrupt your communication. This is very important in quantum cryptography, right? Now, so since this type of cryptography is based on quantum physics and it's not strictly mathematics, the sender and receiver can be confident that no eavesdropper is listening to the communication path used to establish their keys, and that a man in the middle attack is not being carried out. That's what I have told you, that okay, this is impossible that some eavesdropper can listen the communication between the sender and receiver, and definitely man in the middle attack is also not possible in this particular situation. This is because the quantum level, even looking at an atom or a subatomic particle changes its attribute. This means that if there is an eavesdropper carrying out a passive attack, such as sniffing, the receiver would know because just this simple act changed the characteristics, polarization of the photon. अब देखें, ये है वो point जहाँ से आपने आके इस idea को समझना है. वो ये है कि आपके पास photon जो है, it is in the form of subatomic or atomic particle. ये आपके पास atom होते हैं, उसके subatomic particles होते हैं, ठीक है? ये जो particles हैं, when they are traveling, if somebody is going to listen them or somebody is going to, I mean to say that, do certain things with them, they are going to change their shapes. Or you may call it as, they are going to change their attributes. जैसे हमने देखा है ना कि I mean आपका जो कोरोना है, कोरोना वायरस है, ठीक है, इट इज गोइंग टू बी चेंज इट्स शेप टाइम टू टाइम. कि जी पहली जो स्ट्रेन आई थी उसमें जो कोरोना वायरस था उसकी जो शेप थी वो डिफरेंट थी. अब जो है उसने अपनी शेप को चेंज कर लिया एंड देन इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर द वैक्सीन टू ओवरकम दैट पर्टिकुलर सिचुएशन लाइक दैट. द सेम वे अगर आपका जो फोटोन है, आई मीन इफ इट इज ट्रेवलिंग, इफ समबडी इज गोइंग टू लिसन दैट पर्टिकुलर कम्युनिकेशन, तो आपके पास क्या होगा कि जैसे ही वो वेव्स उस पर्टिकुलर फोटोन के साथ स्ट्राइक करेंगी तो ऑटोमेटिकली आपके पास उसकी शेप जो है ना वो चेंज हो जाएगी. एंड व्हेन दैट शेप इज गोइंग टू बी चेंज्ड, और यू मे कॉल इट एज इट्स सम एट्रीब्यूट्स आर गोइंग टू बी चेंज्ड, देन व्हेन द रिसीवर वुड सी दैट इन्फॉर्मेशन, जैसे ही उसको रिसीव होगा, तो अगर वो आपके पास की डिफरेंट है, आई मीन जो कम्युनिकेशन आपके पास हो रही है कि उसकी जो जो टिल्ट था आपका वो डिफरेंट है, तो डेफिनेटली इट वुड बी नोइंग दैट कि देयर इज सम मॉडिफिकेशन और देयर इज सम थिंग दैट माइट हैपन विद दैट पर्टिकुलर डेटा, राइट? सो सच एज स्निफिंग, द रिसीवर वुड नो बिकॉज जस्ट दिस सिंपल एक्ट चेंजेस द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक पोलराइजेशन ऑफ द फोटॉन्स. तो अब अगर वो लेफ्ट टिल्ट था वो राइट टिल्ट हो जाएगा, और अगर वो राइट टिल्ट था तो वो लेफ्ट टिल्ट हो जाएगा, अगर वो हॉरिजेंटल है तो मे बी वो वर्टिकल हो जाएगा, अगर वर्टिकल था तो वो हॉरिजेंटल हो जाएगा. सो दिस मस्ट नॉट बी द केस. इफ समबडी इज गोइंग टू स्निफ दैट इन्फॉर्मेशन, that is going to change its, I mean to say that, attributes, right? This is how your receiver might know that ki aapki jo values hain wo change ho rahi hain. So quantum crypto, this means that as the jelly beans are sent from Cathy to Tom, if scenes tries to view the jelly bean, the ones that were traveling in a horizontal manner could be tilting left, and ones that were traveling in a vertical manner could now be traveling horizontally, right? Some people in the industry thinks quantum cryptography is used between the US White House and the Pentagon, and between some military information, type of information is classified top secret by the US government, and unless you know the secret handshakes and have the right decoding rings, you will not be privy to this type of information, right? So this is the basic idea कि आपके पास क्वांटम क्रिप्टोग्राफी कैसे काम करती है. इफ सीन ट्राइज टू व्यू द जाली बीन्स, तो आपके पास जो वैल्यूज थी दे माइट बी डिफरेंट, राइट? सो आई मीन सो पीपल थिंक दैट दिस टाइप ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन जो क्वांटम क्रिप्टोग्राफी है दैट इज ओनली बीन इम्प्लीमेंटेड बिटवीन द यूएस व्हाइट हाउस एंड द पेंटागन. आई मीन दीज आर द वेरी टू सीक्रेट, आई मीन वेरी टॉप लेवल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन लाइक यूएस व्हाइट हाउस में, उसमें आपका प्रेजिडेंट यूएस रहता है, एंड पेंटागन इज अ वेरी सिक्योर एजेंसी ऑफ यूएस, right? So if they used to communicate, they might not be using the normal cryptographic techniques like symmetric, asymmetric, or like that. That might be compromised, right? So what they think? They think that they used to communicate between these two entities, used to communicate using a quantum cryptography so that nobody can compromise their communication, right? So this is the basic idea of a quantum cryptography, right? So that's all regarding the quantum cryptography. So if anybody have any question, he or she may ask, so that we can start understanding the internet security, right? So let's start with any question.
Sir, yes sir, ye jo quantum cryptography hoti hai wo sirf aur sirf key distribution ke liye istemal karenge hum.
Exactly key distribution. Ab key distribution ke andar aapki jab symmetric wo ho jayegi, complete ho jayegi, to fir usme hum kya karenge ke key distribution to nahi hum keh sakte. I mean jo symmetric key hamare paas kya hoti hai, I mean same at the sender end as well as at the receiver's end. To ab hamare paas jo bhi encryption hogi by through this particular symmetric keys. तो अब ऑन द वे अगर आपके पास आपका डेटा या जो भी आपके पास हो रहा है उसके अंदर कोई चेंज होता है या कुछ भी होता है, तो डेफिनेटली वो डिक्रिप्ट नहीं हो पाएगा एट द रिसीवर्स एंड,